Yes, we are live now.
Hi everyone, and welcome to this wonderful, wonderful live I am thrilled and very, very honored to be here. I'm going to begin by saying that I know the least amongst everyone here about this whole project. So my job and my role here is to be a moderator and hopefully to provide a little entertainment because I'm a little crazy, as Matthew knows. But I just wanted to say thank you. It's an honor to be here. It's an honor always to do anything for Magic Bus. And I must say that I heard this track and I couldn't stop listening to it. Voices United. I was so moved. I had tears in my eyes. And I think I would like to start by saying it is a wonderful tribute to the frontline workers, to everyone who's coming together and come together in this very difficult time. Everyone in the world has literally been united by the crises that is COVID. And I think the one thing that has brought everyone and getting everyone through is unity. And I think that comes across so beautifully in this wonderful track with 14 amazing veteran musicians from all across the country with different languages. And I got our kids to watch it too, who were very moved as well. And I think everyone's struggles in this time have obviously been different. And while for someone like me, it's about work from home and homeschooling and jumping around with kids and going a little crazy with all that, there are so many people who've lost their livelihoods, who've not been able to go to school. And I think it's amazing that organizations like Magic Bus, together with UNESCO, Metalloid, Dukes, Padma Shri Usha Uttap Ji, the Shillong Choir, and of course Matthew, that all of you have come together to help actually get these 200,000 people back into the workforce, and I believe 300,000 children back to school. So it's really, really humbling to have heard the song and to see the amazing work you're doing. And before I get into introducing each of you and asking you questions, and then I will shut up, I just want to say that, you know, I don't want to reveal my age, but suffice to say, it was near the beginning of Matthew beginning Magic Bus, and he revealed that number a while ago. I was very young, and I was very confused. I was deciding whether I wanted to act or I wanted to continue in the corporate world at Accenture in London. I chose to act and be in the entertainment space, but it was Matthew and Magic Bus that very kindly said, while you're in this process of indecision, why don't you work with us and, you know, maybe do a little bit of an internship. I got much more from Magic Bus than I think I gave, but I really saw firsthand the passion, the commitment, and the incredible work that Matthew and the team of Magic Bus were doing. And it's commendable to see that, you know, I think from 3,000 kids' lives being transformed, I think it's now over a million lives, That's children's right. lives, who've moved from, you know, a life of challenge to one of meaningful livelihood. So congratulations, Matthew and Magic Bus. And this is a fantastic initiative.
You're one of our best fundraisers. I mean, everyone kept wanting you to come back to their offices, and you just we're very sad we lost you, but you've gone on to do amazing things for us and for Magic Bus and for yourself. So thank you and congratulations to you as well.
Thank you and congratulations all of you. As I said, the track is wonderful and it's a fantastic initiative. So I'm going to get straight to the little script I've been sent. When I'm doing my own show, I try hard not to read from a paper. It's a little tip my dad, Pratap Sharma, when he was known for his speaking, he would always say, don't read, but I can't help it. I'm very sorry. I have to read just because I only just received this and I don't want to leave anything out. So basically, it says here, the pandemic over the last few months has given the nation much reason to lose hope and faith. But one reason to assure us we will make it through no matter what is the strength of our unity, as I said earlier. And India has really shown the world that we shall overcome any obstacle that comes our way. Voices United is a multilingual, multi-artist audio-video track honoring this strength. And it features 14 veteran artists from across the country, produced by Sounds of Silence in partnership with Dukes, United Nations, UNESCO, with Magic Bus as the exclusive charity partner and Zee Music and 9XM Music as the music partners. So I'd just like to introduce our panelists here. We have Pritish Kulati, the founder of Metalloid Entertainment and Media Network, who has conceptualized this initiative. Hi, Pritish. We have Eric Falt from UNESCO. Eric Falt is the director and UNESCO representative for the UNESCO New Delhi office, covering Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Nepal, the Maldives, and Sri Lanka. He has more than 30 years of experience in various roles with the United Nations. Bonjour, Eric.
Hello, hello. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Hi.
And we've got Anoop Tharavat from Dukes. Dukes has transformed into India's largest biscuits, cookies, wafers, and confectionery manufacturer with formidable global exports portfolio. Hi, Anoop.
Hello. Hi, Tara. Hi, everyone.
Hi.
And of course, we've got the gorgeous Padma Shri Usha Utto, the darling of pop music in India. Padma Shri Usha Utto has, for 50 years, charmed generations of music lovers with her foot-tapping music. Our Usha Di has transformed the Indian music scenario with her impeccable style. Thank you, Usha Ji, for being
you.
Here.
Thank you. Thanks, love. Thanks for having me here. Thank you.
And we have William Richmond from the Shillong Choir. The Shillong Choir, which actually came to fame after winning the reality talent show India's Got Talent in October 2010, but they were always very talented. So I always dislike it when talent shows take credit for discovering talent that was there. But congratulations on that. And they are renowned for performing Western chorals as well as choral style revamps of Hindi film Bollywood classics. Hi, William. Thank you for being here.
Hello.
Hi. Yeah. And of course, we have Matthew Spacey from Magic Bus India Foundation. Matthew is the founder of Magic Bus, an NGO working with children and young people in India, moving them out of poverty. Matthew's vision, undying commitment to innovation and social change has been elemental in making Magic Bus one of the top five NGOs in India. Woohoo! So, on that note, I'm going to get to the questions, but before I do that, I want to tell all our viewers, firstly, I wish I could see you, because when I'm speaking live, I like to see people, but I'm imagining...
Don't we all?
I know, but I'm imagining you're all there, and please, 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 the objective is this, of this, is for you to hear the track and also to donate. And as Matthew said, I'm actually not very good at fundraising, but I will spell that out right at the start. If you'd like to donate, please donate at www.magicbus.org and help restore incomes of 200,000 families, ensuring that at least 300,000 children stay in school and complete their education. So let us begin with Pritish. Pritish, how did you conceptualize Sounds of Silence and Voices United, and why?
Thanks, Tara. So Sounds of Silence is actually an intellectual property that is owned by Metalloid. We founded that intellectual property in 2016. This intellectual property primarily caters to more of an emotional quotient of an individual than an outright concert or an outright show. And during this pandemic, when we were sitting at home without much of the entire economy down and the entertainment industry down, it was in fact my partner who said, let's go and give a tribute to all the frontline workers and everyone out there who are really, really working out, you know, when keeping us safe and monitoring the streets and helping people during the pandemic situation. That's when we had realized that, you know, it is out of a personal experience that we've realized that India, though it's one nation, but is quite divided into north, south, and east and west. Though we speak English, though we speak Hindi predominantly, it's been quite a multicultural and multilingual nation. What got us thinking is it's one country, and all languages united together keeps us going. And it's united we stand, divided we fall. So coming together is what is most important for us, and that's the birth of how Voices and it had started. And thank you to all the artists, Eric, Anoop, Matthew, Ushaji, Shillong Choir, for everybody trusting in us and coming on board and saying, let's do something together. This itself is a great example of unity. Eric sits in France, but still took out the time to go ahead and have a conversation with us, keeping in mind the time difference as well, and keeping in mind a busy schedule of singers like Ushaji and the Shillong Choir and Raghu Dixit and so on. They have come forward and they put their step forward and said, let's do something unique and different. So that's exactly what happened, and that's how the song came out.
Wonderful. And it's, as I said, it's a beautiful, beautiful song, and it definitely does hit at the heartstring. So you did get that emotional part very right. And Eric, what made UNESCO partner with the Voices United project?
Well, we're living in a rather strange period where the whole world has been forced to place normal life on hold because of COVID-19. And I think it's important to fight on several fronts to alleviate the impact of the disease. Of course, doctors, nurses, and medical personnel in general are on the front lines, but everybody can have a role to play. And at UNESCO, and because of our mandate, we have first and foremost emphasized the role of educationists, but we also believe in the power of culture and the arts. And in times of constraints and restrictions on our daily routines, we hope that music too would encourage people to come together to face the current COVID-19 pandemic. Music is one of the most accessible forms of stress relievers, mood boosters, but it also gives an opportunity in general to people to collectively make a difference while staying distance. And that is what we really liked in Voices United, and that's why it was quite natural that we associate with the project.
Wonderful. That's fantastic. And I am going to go back now to British to ask how and why you selected Magic Bus as your partner NGO.
Sure. So whilst we were conceptualizing the entire song, the lyrics, working in partnership with UNESCO and Dukes, got us thinking that, you know, with this particular song and our marketing and our communication, connecting with people, our reach is our strength. And it only made sense to add a viable reason, not just to put a song out there, but hopefully create a platform for another entity to maybe benefit off it. It was an absolute non-commercial project from our end. But keeping that in mind, we wanted to see if anybody out there could benefit out of it. And not just through watching the song and visualizing what's happening there. And a dear friend from Singapore, Purnima, had connected me to Sheetal and the Magic Bus team, went through the entire project, went through the entire understanding of what Magic Bus does. What really caught my attention was Magic Bus was focusing on supporting children with their education. And that's something that I hold very dear. And as a company also, we do have about 5-6 children that we take care of in terms of education and supporting their entire annual fund. That got our attention and said, if we could maybe create a difference, if we could provide a platform to them, not that they need one, but any additional support is good support, especially during these tough times. So that got our attention. And after a detailed conversation and, to and fro with Sheetal and the entire team, Magic Bus thankfully came on board, which added a lot of value, to be honest. It wasn't a value in vain. It was a value to really push forward the entire agenda or the motive of the video or the project.
Wonderful. And Matthew, what do you think of partnerships like this? As in, what does it bring to Magic Bus and the other way around, collaborations like this?
Thank you, Tara. And by the way, I said you were a very good fundraiser. I didn't say you were. We were very excited.
I know. I said you said I was a very good fundraiser, but I said to you before I did that I'm a very bad fundraiser. Anyway, that's a story for another day. I have such respect for people who are able to fundraise.
But first of all, thank you, Pritesh and Eric, and to Dukes, to Ushaji, to the Shillong Choir and everyone. Thank you very much, first of all, from Magic Bus. And it is all about creating a broader platform for us as an organization, because there is so much work to be done. And, we're completely impotent as an organization acting by ourselves. And we really need so many people to participate, especially now in all these massive challenges. You know, someone was saying to me the other day, you know, asking me what it was like now working for a nonprofit, and it really is almost double the work with half the money. And so, you know, there has to be a new era, I think, in our, you know, in the country, which is about, you know, working on this in a far more collaborative manner, you know, in every aspect, you know, whether it's about government or civic society or corporations. So thank you all very much for participating. It's a, hopefully things, it follows a theme which I hope will continue as well over the next chapter of India's history. But for us, it was, you know, it was really interesting for us because we are a poverty alleviation organization. We, you know, we've worked, I think, with just nearly just under 1.5 million children. We've, you know, got good metrics to suggest that we've taken them out of poverty. It's an interesting program because we take children on this journey from childhood to livelihood. So they hopefully stay with us for 7 years. And we really look up, try and make sure that they stay in school, that they don't get married. But most importantly, at the end of all of that, we're able to get them jobs. And so we sort of focus on those three areas. And that was, you know, growing and doing so well. And of course, then this extraordinary event happened. But what we realized is because our program actually is unusual in that we have about 2,000 staff who are working and paid by Magic Bus, but we have about 10,000 community workers who are the touch points, the coalface, the front, sort of the front line, if you like, of our work, who are young people who are incredibly motivated to move their own communities out of poverty. And so they are the people who actually do all the work for us. And it was really, much of this was driven by them. And they came back and said, we can't do what we normally do, but we're seeing our communities just buckle under this new horrific sort of, you know, this horrific challenge, which we now have, you know, and obviously they were at the brunt of seeing many of the people returning, those city labor, people going out of work, you know, obviously people, you know, we had a survey which has told us that since the 22nd of March, about 50% of our, 55% of our communities haven't received any income. And so, you know, we work in 22 states, so it's a pretty representative figure of those people, those 700-800 million people who are already challenged, aren't receiving income. So you kind of give us a sense of what it must be like to be a young person growing up with such a bleak view. And they came to us and we with them crafted a response mechanism which enabled us to get, I think, 25 million meals out to the families in their own communities.
Wow, really fantastic.
And you know, and so we, you know, obviously in many ways, and everyone on this call will agree, raising the money is damn hard, very difficult to raise money. But imagine going out with all the fear that we had in March of all dying very quickly from this thing, and they were going out and just being on the, just doing the work, you know, and so it was just such a privilege for us to raise money for them, I think, and represent them in some way. But they were out there delivering food. We've had mask making factories. We had delivering to hospitals. We were making masks for hospitals and delivering food packages to hospitals. And this is, when I say we, I'm saying the 10,000 young people who aren't paid a rupee by Magic Bus, but they're actually doing much of the work, as well as obviously the support they got from our very brave staff. So that's what really this song is about. You know, it's about mobilizing when these young people, you know, and the resilience they show and the stories we've got, and no time now to tell those stories, but you can just imagine really the heroes that were born out of this last 6 months of people doing extraordinary things.
Absolutely. I think it's incredible, as you said, Matthew, to hear these stories and love to hear more, you know, because of course we read about and we see and we hear about, you know, the frontline workers, people going out, volunteering, and, you know, with all the restrictions. I mean, just as a layperson, I know how much life has changed. And as I say, everyone's journey is so different, and how extreme some people's life, how extremely they've changed. I have to say, and this is again, some things are not scripted, so I hope that's okay. But I must say, another thing that I've always observed with Magic Bus and Matthew is you have really honestly mastered the art of successfully fundraising and also slightly corporatizing this whole industry, which, as I think you mentioned briefly in the beginning, is just so important, because in many ways people are doing double or triple the work and earning half or less. So I think there's a desperate need for that. And it's wonderful to have conversations like this with people who are decision makers in these areas who can actually make a change. And I'm not now going to change the order a bit. So if people have a script, then don't be surprised. But I want to come now to actually Padmashree Usha Uthup ji and ask you, Usha ji, that I know you've collaborated with Magic Bus before. And as you were mentioning to Matthew, you've loved doing that. So what about this particular project, inspired you or enticed you to join in, or how did the whole collaboration happen?
Okay, let me tell you something. For me, this is most important, and with all my humility and honesty and gratitude, I'd like to say thank you to everybody for including me in this project. Because, you know, having been I've been singing for 51 years now, and I've done any amount of shows for all different kinds of charities. One doesn't talk about it because it's not nice to talk about the good things that one tries to do. It's unless you want to mobilize something, then you have to talk about it. But, you know, I've always wanted, and I've been a grabber, okay? I grab at every opportunity I get to get some kind of happiness and use my, whatever my services would be, which is musical, of course. And whenever I get that chance, then I just jump at it. I don't leave it, because I think the most fantastic thing in the world for any artist is to be asked, because we have to worry about the time when nobody asks for us. And I hope that never really happens. So I am so grateful to everybody for giving me a chance to be on this amazing, amazing project. Now, coming to this collaboration, let me tell you something. For me, it was, I'm not even sure who really asked me first. But let me tell you that as far as the pandemic is concerned and Corona is concerned, you know, it's the single power that has got the whole world on its knees. I mean, I hate it so much. I've never used the word hate because it's such a horrible word. And I'm not a person like that. I'm a happy person. I'm 100%, compulsive optimist. But I really hate this. I mean, you know, it's just unbelievable. And, you know, every day there are people who we know of and, you know, our loved ones who are all, we're losing all of them to COVID. And we're the only people, I mean, we're only just, I'm talking for just around me and around our little neighborhood and around our city and around the village and then the world. And then you realize how small the world really is. And finally, we have realized that we are all absolutely the same. We're in the same boat, brother. And it is such a beautiful feeling to know that we all have learned to care, love, share, give. I mean, give unashamedly, I've always done. And I think that is so important. So whenever I get an opportunity in the pandemic, I've been saying to everybody in all, whether it was motivational speeches or whatever, that, you know, if you try to glean the good things that have come out of it, and one of the most fantastic things that has come out of the corona is the fact that we've all truly been together. And when we get another chance to be together like this, I mean, you'd be foolish not to really get involved with it. So when I was told that this is, a song like this, in any case, inspires everybody, isn't it? When you say hum honge kamyab, or you say we shall overcome. And I think of the time when I had the opportunity of singing this with Pete Seeger himself, in India, in Calcutta. Can you imagine? Wow. I mean, well, really, yeah, it was really wow. I feel very proud to say it as well. And then to get a chance when Pritesh asked me, I think it was Pritesh, actually, excuse me, who asked me first. And I said, of course I will. I mean, there's no two ways about it. Yeah. I mean, I'm just happy that you asked me. And I had no idea that... you know, Magic Bus was in it. Magic Bus is my dream bus. I mean, I think there's nothing so beautiful as the Magic Bus. There's no bus, double-decker or single-decker bus, that gives so much to people and has done so much for people. So Magic Bus, when I knew that Magic Bus was involved, which was much, much later, and actually then I get to hear that it's Magic Bus's baby, right? So it's just fantastic. And when I heard about all who all were performing in this, I was even more inspired to do this because I'm a very people person. And though I do a lot of, during the pandemic, we've done about 150 shows. And as you said earlier, it's not all about money, really, because I didn't make money during all these shows and 150 shows that I've done during the corona times. But the kind of goodwill that you're able to generate and the kind of things that you can do is really amazing. Wow. So my entire process of, being in this collaboration has been one of joy. And really, when I say joy, for me, it matters a lot. I suppose in this whole gang, I would probably be the senior most artist, having worked for 51 years and been a nightclub singer. So for me, it was... I feel thrilled. I feel absolutely thrilled that I was involved with it. And if there is any way that I can be of use to anybody, whether it's UNESCO, or whether it's Magic Bus, or whether it's Metalloid, or whether it's Duke, or whether it's anybody, I would be thrilled to do it. But doing it for my bus,
yeah.
Oh, I just loved that. And that was the first thing that got me when I was introduced to him so many years ago. The name Magic Bus just conjures up such amazing images, isn't it? That you can really get magic out of this bus. And we have all got magic out of it. I've seen it working. I've seen the way they work. I've seen the way Matthew's been doing these things. And I'm really, really thrilled to be a part of it. Thank you so much for including me. And remember, stay safe, stay well, stay happy. And healthy. Really, there's nothing more important than love, of course, for me, and good health. Without good health, nothing happens. And there's wretched corona. Oh, I don't know what to do with it. You don't know where it's lurking, and you don't know. You just don't know where is it happening.
I think what's so wonderful, Usha ji, everything you said, and I think what really, really resonates, I think, for all of us is good health for us all, for everyone, is the most important thing, touch wood. And I think finding the silver linings in a very difficult time silver lining. And I think one of those, apart from giving joy and unity and collaborations like this and helping others, I think another big thing, and you are really an example of it, is reinvention.
You rediscover, you revisit. You Absolutely. Reboot. And, you know, there was a time when even 6 months back, when 6th of March was my last show in Jodhpur. And just even before that, a week before that, I was telling everybody that I'm so tech unsavvy and, you know, I don't know anything about it. And, you know, to many people, it is very fashionable to say that, you know, that I don't know how to manage all these things. But let me tell you, I had to eat humble pie because there was no other way for me but to learn how to get on with it. And I did. And today I have this little, just as far as my hands go, is what my studio is all about and where I do all my shows from. Whether it's, as I said, whether it's a double-decker bus or single, I'm in this bus all the time. And I'm so thrilled to say that I've learned how to do it. I have two iPhones. One iPhone does the shooting, one does the music, and I have a little mixer, and I've done everything on my, including the little lights at the back.
That is fabulous, fabulous, fabulous. And again, I think tech, as much as I scream about our kids being on the screen too much, and I really miss physical school, I also see the huge advantages that technology has.
Of course.
Enabled all of us to be together like this. And William, I'd like to ask you now about the actual process of recording this track. What was the experience like for you, and how did it feel to actually record a track when you weren't with, your fellow musicians, or how did you do it, especially as a choir?
I think we've gotten quite used to it, being tucked away in the northeast part of India and having to sing with musicians all over the world. That part wasn't so challenging, but it was sticking to our principles and adhering to what the government told us of things like social distancing and having done studies and knowing that singing is one way of spreading the aerosols more than even talking.
Yeah.
record these pieces, I think I remember telling Pritish as well, that normally we record it as a choir as a whole, you know, so you get the whole feel of it. But we had to be sincere. Nobody would have known about it, but we had to be sincere about it. We went one after the other in the studio. It was not just all individual. So, I mean, we have to practice what we tell others to do as well. And like Ma'am Usha said, I mean, it's hit everybody bad. It's hit the artist bad as well. But to, you know what, one saying I think engulfs it all that brings the most joy. It says to serve while the gout is eating at your own bones. And there is nothing more wonderful than that. And this was a small little opportunity that we took advantage of to serve our fellow human beings. And of course, like Magic Bus and everybody that's involved in all of this, it was such a wonderful process. And I was telling Pritish said, listen, why don't you just sing this particular section? And we decided to sing it in Khasi.
Oh, wow.
Okay, so we did it in Khasi. And of course, Usha ma'am has sung in Khasi, I'm sure, many times before.
Yes, of course.
So we sang it in our tribal language. And I said, no, let us go the extra mile. Because it's so human to do the first mile, but it's divine to go the second mile. So I said, let's add some more choruses at the end. Let's rouse up the song even more. And then when we heard it with every other voice, and when the video eventually came out, we was just so happy to be a part of this whole thing. And it's been months that this has been on the road now. You know, this bus has been on the road since God knows when, Pritish. June, July, August, somewhere around that time?
Yeah, June.
I remember. So here we are still at it. And that's the beauty of it. Endurance is what makes the human spirit. And for artists, yeah, if you talk about recording, it's tough. But we've had to, like it says, necessity is the mother of invention. We've had to have our own virtual studio now where we're doing concerts from home. We've had to cancel about 15 to 20 shows because we can't travel. And although we can, but we won't, because it's irresponsible from our part to do so.
That's wonderful. And I think all of you are an amazing example of being able to carry on and move forward regardless of the obstacles and, you know, embrace technology and all the other ways to actually make that happen. But as the creator and producer of my own show, the Tara Sharma Show, I also know if it weren't for some very generous donations and sponsors, not all our dreams would be possible. So that is going to come bring me now to the presenting sponsors, who I believe is Dukes. And I'd like to ask you, Anoop, you know, how you got involved and what Dukes is doing, you know, apart from this, when it comes to COVID relief in society. And hats off, because I'm always pitching to brands, so don't be alarmed if you get a message from me after this. I'm just joking. But the truth is that it is wonderful when, you know, money follows conversation. So that's also for all of you out there. Please do donate. I think the link will be in the description. So please donate. Yes, I know. Do tell us.
Thanks, Tara. First and foremost, it feels really great to be a part of this wonderful team. And Dukes takes pride in associating with Voices United and collaborating with all the wonderful souls out here. You're trying to contribute in a really a great way. I think it's really great to be a part of this. And, COVID has made this world a very secluded place, right? The world needs hope more than ever. Every small act of kindness or joy, means a lot more than ever, right? So I think Voices United was also about, how do we bring unity? How do we stand together in terms of communicating this? And I think that resonated really well with Dukes, because we believe in it, and that's at the core of whatever that we try to do, right? So, but again, like it said, it really brought in a lot of challenges for us, from a business perspective. The consumer, purchasing powers have, or patterns have drastically, changed. It has put us a lot of pressure in us. But at the same time, it was, equally important for us to you know, see how better we can, you know, serve a society, right? How better we can deliver things that we have been always doing in a much more efficient manner. And Dukes is has always been and is continuing, to work in this space. And in line with this, you know, as a socially responsible brand, we always believe in giving back to our society. So the couple of things, especially in line with COVID, what we're trying to do is we distributed our food products for free for our migrant workers who are struggling to, you know, go back to their hometowns in the initial days, right? We distributed free food products to the frontline workers, the hospital things, you know, round the clock. We've been working day and night to help, the COVID people and things along those lines. Our employees donated, their salaries, to help the people out there. And I can keep on saying a couple of things, on and on again. But what is more important that, you know, as a brand, as an individual, it is important that we all come together during this tough time, stand together, give a ray of hope for a lot of people out there, come out together on a very positive note. I think it is again great to be a part of this team.
Wonderful. That's fabulous. And I think everyone, my favorite line in doing my show is each to their own. I think everyone's able to contribute and help in different ways. Some people perhaps with funds, some people perhaps with awareness, some people perhaps with spreading the word. So it's wonderful that you've all been able to contribute in your way. Eric, how does this whole project tie in with UNESCO's vision and with UNESCO's goals, and how do you see the future when it comes to online? How much of, because I like to say that honestly, as much as it's been a terribly trying, difficult time, there are some silver linings. And I often say to our own kids, I hope we go back to the good part, but I hope we actually let go of the not so good part of the old normal. So personally, I've found that the family bonding and honestly, the quality time that many of us have been able to spend with our children working from home, of course, lots of fights as well, but little things, you know, being much more mindful of people around, being able to help maybe staff, even if it's not, being as magnanimous as going out and volunteering in a bigger context. I think everyone, at least that I've come in contact with, is way more aware of their immediate. So for an organization like UNESCO, how do you think the future looks when it comes to online? Do you think we'll go back to the way things were? Do you think we'll use some of these new ways of working and doing? Yeah.
Well, I think, as you say, there have been some silver linings in this crisis. But I think what we will all agree on is that we've been forced to evolve, and it's not finished. And I think the first aspect, and it's been underlined by other speakers before, is that we've been forced to evolve in the way we communicate. With the majority of the world under lockdown, what we call content production in general and consumption has primarily shifted to digital platforms. We didn't have a choice. Of course, this was already a trend, but it has accelerated, and people of all ages have been forced to use sometimes new media. I mean, for instance, we're using Zoom today. Who even knew of Zoom 9 months ago?
Nobody knew.
Such technology. So quite clearly, we have to look at this. This is the way to go. And organizations like UNESCO, all UN organizations, have been forced to accelerate changes in the way they are communicating. And obviously, it often boils down to products that can be seen on the internet or otherwise, but visually. And we have a number of such projects under development for us. And if I want to simplify, because we don't have the time here, but the idea is that we support projects that bring people together wherever they may be. That's the role of UNESCO in general. And of course, with our New Delhi office, we focus more specifically on projects related to South Asia. In this case, it was quite, as I said, quite natural that we associate with Voices United. And I really want to recognize again Pritish, because he was the heart and soul of the project. The message of this particular project is universal, at least the overall message, but at the same time, it is so perfectly attuned to India. And it's really wonderful to have seen so many artists come together. And I hope that for other projects as well, we can reach out and work with other musicians in particular.
That's fantastic.
Lovely.
Yeah, that's
and
wonderful.
Count me in.
We will.
Yes, absolutely.
I have lost track of time, but I also lost track because I'm actually not very tech savvy. I'm learning from our children and my husband, but and my mother, who's actually become better at tech than me in this time. But basically, I forgot to look at the chat box, which is messages to me. And apparently, we are coming close to the end of the time, but there are still some questions left. So what I thought, because I think in this lovely interactive session, people have spoken a lot and everything's sort of been covered. So what I'd really like to do is maybe go just one quick round with each person saying one thing that they'd still like to say, but quite short because I think we don't have much time. So just one like closing comment on how you think, you know, what the future looks like and how you think there could be more collaborations like this. And what the listeners, the viewers, basically, if you could give a line to our viewers and imagine they're all there clapping and screaming. And that's what I do when I'm doing these events, because it's weird not to have them actually there. But what would you say to our viewers? And also, I would love, if it's possible, for Usha Ji and William to sing a little bit, if that's possible. Is that possible?
For me? I'm ready anytime you ask. So anytime you ask, I'm just ready to sing because I have absolutely, as I said, one should worry when nobody asks you. So even you, even if you hadn't asked, I would have said, please let me sing a song.
Nobody will ever stop asking you, believe me. And as
okay, so
dad,
you ask all the comments and I can wind up.
Okay, let's have one comment each and then let's have a little bit of singing. That's okay. So should we begin with... Pritish, one closing comment for our viewers.
So I do agree, you know, in today's day and age, the pandemic is a very unforeseen situation. The last time we had a pandemic was about a century ago, 1919, when the Spanish influenza affected us. And exactly a century later, it kind of took us by, you know, the surprise when no one really knew. But, you know, there's a very old saying that I always... follow very religiously, you know. A tiger always takes two steps back to jump 4 feet ahead or 4 steps ahead. Every time mankind has come with a challenging situation, we've always outdone ourselves. We are survivors, and we are a species that will overcome any sort of situation for the, and that affects our survival and that affects our near India. That being said, I must really thank Eric and Anoop and Matthew and all the artists that were a part of this, because irrespective of how much a producer goes ahead and composes or ideates content, it is at the end of the day an entire team effort that comes together. It's Sheetal and the entire Magic Bus team and Metalloids team as well. Thank you so much. Thank you for trusting in us. Eric, I hope to work with you again. Matthew, same thing with you. Ushaji and William, we'd love to have shows with you all. Tara, I did watch an episode of yours with MS Dhoni last night. And Rohit Sharma. So I do hope to get in touch with you again sometime with regards to talk shows. Thank you so much for trusting in us. And let's hope the best for this project going forward.
Thanks, Pritish, and well done on a fantastic initiative and a fantastic IP, a word that I know well, as the IP of my show is mine. So IP is an important thing. And closing comments from Anoop.
It's great. I see music is the best unifier when unity becomes the need of the hour, right? And that's what we did, you know, through Voices United. On behalf of Dukes, I request all the people who is watching this out right now to support each other, you know, to be for each other, stay united, come together. And it is important that, you know, by doing this, we all come out, you know, out of this on a very positive note. And one last thing is about, you know, a crisis like this always gives us choices as well, right? Like how Ushaji rightly, you know, explained, you know, how she was able to do everything on her own, right? So innovations are happening at great scale during this time. Let's make use of this let us make this world a better place post-COVID.
Thank you, Anup. That's lovely. And closing comments from Matthew. By the way, Matthew, how are you coping with three kids homeschooling? That's another question for another day, but are you all right?
No, I'm not. I think that's been a journey by itself. But anyway.
So no, closing comment.
Yeah. I think, I think this is it's a really good opportunity to set, the pause button's been set. And I think it's a really good opportunity for us to reflect on how we now want to build our nation. And, what I would say is that by and large, what we've been doing in the past hasn't worked for 90% of the people that live in this great country. And it's such an opportunity with this extraordinary event to start thinking about being extraordinary ourselves and challenging all our past behavior so that we could be a bit more inclusive and build a better India.
Wonderful. Fabulous, Matthew. And you really have been walking the talk ever since I met you. And Eric, is there a closing comment you have?
We all individually or collectively go through moments of despair, but the human spirit always overcomes, and we will overcome together, preferably with music.
Wonderful. Thank you. Thanks, Eric. And on that note, may we have the two wonderful musicians give a closing comment and then burst into song. And I cannot join you because I cannot sing to save my life. But if anyone else would like to join in, please do.
Also, the thing about the digital platform, the only thing that they have not perfected. I mean, it's wonderful that you can do a show in Seattle or you can do a show in Chicago sitting in a little room in Calcutta. And, it's really, really amazing. And that's such a big takeaway to know that we're all together with people like UNESCO and Magic Bus supporting us. What else do we want? But really, let me tell you that the one thing that the digital world hasn't been able to do for us is to, I'm the person who loves people to sing along with me, but that's just impossible because of the delay factor, whenever you're performing and somebody, you said, I remember in my first two shows, it was disaster because everybody was singing and it was all different timings. And it was so difficult for you to, so then I realized that this is what happens when, especially with Zoom, it's very, very difficult. But my closing comments on this amazing afternoon has been that I've always said that music is not my business, communication is. And I am so grateful to all of you for having me a part of this project. Thank you very much, because I wouldn't have it any other way. So if your bus is going, and UNESCO is on it, and Eric is on it, and Pritesh is on it, and everybody else on everybody. Remember, I'm there as well. Maybe you could buy my ticket for me because we're really broke. We don't get paid for nothing, but it's great fun. And it's really wonderful. And thank you for having me here. So after Shillong Choir talks, and then I will sing your song.
Wonderful. William?
I wish it was the Shillong Chamber Choir, all of us. I'm just here, one of the few faces from the entire choir. But after hearing all of you speak, like each one of you said, like Eric and as Matthew as well said, that it's the human spirit that prevails out of this entire situation. And never have I, me personally and everybody else, I think life was moving too fast. I think we lost track of time. We lost track of our family and our loved ones and ourselves. And in one sense, you have to also look to what this pandemic has done. It has given you time to reflect, especially inwardly, and take stock of who you actually are and who actually I am. Before it's too late, before we look back and say, what, life is over already? So that's what I've learned. And as musicians as well, we've learned to reinvent ourselves. We've learned to build new things from scratch. Otherwise, we were touring all the time and we couldn't get back to our music. So I'm so glad that this point of time that, like Usha ma'am said, that people have come to us several
occasions that we've sung for them and raised funds. And we are doing our own little efforts as well, feeding these people and that people, and having our little bits in here and there. But, you know, let my right hand not know what my left hand is doing. That's for people to find out and not for me to tell. But yes, I think I will like to thank each one of you and everybody for including the Shillong Chamber Choir, be a part of such a noble event. And for it to still continue after all these months in itself shows the genuine cause that's behind it. It could have been a flash in the pan story, just a moment of stardom for everybody to be there and, you know, to be recognized. But the fact that Pritish and everybody else is still continuing just shows that this is genuine stuff. And I thank God that we could be a part of something so real and we could do our little bit. So thank you, Tara, for being such a wonderful mediator as well.
Thank you. Thank you, William. And
thank you, Tara.
Thank you. Thank you so much, all of you. And we'd love to hear a little bit of the singing. And then yes. I just make one last appeal for all our viewers to donate. And yes.
Tara, is it possible that we could auction the song? I hope everybody donates, whoever's there out watching us.
Everyone who's out there, do donate and generously, whatever you're able to. I always think, you know, that's so subjective what people are able to give, but do, because it really helps. A little bit goes a long way. And we'd love to hear you.
Thank you. Tell me something. Would you like me to sing a Hindi song or an English one? Whatever. Or maybe say Sibon, 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 love is savored in France. Sibon, Sibon. Now I'll do you a Hindi song. Okay, everybody?
Yep, come on. Woo!
Okay, so let me sing you this song which won me the Filmfare Award. It's in Hindi, but I'm sure it doesn't matter to you because I'm sure even though you're French, you would definitely understand Hindi. And I'll tell you what it means. It means, say, darling, okay? The name of the song is just darling, okay? That's easy to understand. That's what they say everywhere. So let's go. आँखों से आँखें चार करने दो रुकना रुकना मुझको प्यार Darling, na khushi, aankh char karne do. Rukna, mujhko pyar karne do. Darling, na khushi, aankh char karne do. Rukna, mujhko pyar karne do. Dikhe the bahara, bin jaane yara, bulbul, abhi intezaar karne do. Darling, na khushi, aankh char karne do. Brilliant being with all of you. Love you so much. Woohoo! Darling, sorry to change. Sunday ke din, rehmat li. Darling, sorry to change. Khadim ko dil pe tu ikhtiyar karne do darling na khushi aankh char karne do rukna rukna mujhko pyar karne do darling chodo sarra sharmani ka ye पब्लिक में सनसनी एक बार करने दो डार्लिंग आंखों से आंखें चार करने दो रकना रुको सी व्हाट यू डू सी व्हाट हैपेंस या बट यू मेक डू राइट and somehow or the other more Absolutely. As I always say it's better to be most important to be a good camouflage artist and not such a good artist even I if you're not a good singer it. Be a good camouflage artist and know that it doesn't matter really if the sound goes off so what
I thought that was darling on the phone I thought that was darling phoning you
no that's not a phone at all no it's just the internet that does this to me here oh you okay. can't help it
This is the beauty of improvised reinvention. Everything is okay.
There's nothing you can do. Nothing you can do but smile and say, "Hey, that's what it is. The new normal."
Yeah. So wonderful.
As a fellow
performer, you can clap for me anyway. Don't look so serious, Mr. Pritish.
Fabulous.
Pritish, I'll see you outside. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Hopefully, you'll go bombarding probably.
Yes, I'll see you outside for
that
sure.
That was super.
You owe me big time.
Oh, yes, ma'am, I do.
Big time.
Fabulous. And William, we'd love to hear you.
Do you know how legendary that lady from Calcutta is? She's come to our house, by the way, here in Shillong.
Yeah.
You know, as a fellow performer, I've learned so much from her as well. Stagecraft in particular. I mean, it's very difficult to do what she does. And that too, off the cuff, like you said just now, it's more important to be a camouflage artist. God.
Most important. Because, you know, you can make, anything can go wrong, but you just carry on.
Exactly. And how that has helped us in life as well. So I'm going to sing after that performance, I'm going to sing a song, which is
I thought you would sing first, but then you said you were only one person, so I said okay, I would sing. Otherwise, I'd have finished.
Just something simple, just something small,
lovely, yeah,
something meaningful. Great. As well. I wish the choir was here, but
I know
in rehearsals, but for another time, maybe. And the screen is too small, so this is a song called You Raise Me Up, and I think we all have that one thing in life which we can say has raised us up. And especially at a difficult time like this, the lyrics speak for themselves. And this song has taken me through life as well, you know, to the difficult times of life. And
and mine too. It's my favorite song as well.
Yeah, it's a beautiful, beautiful piece. So I'll sing it for all of you now. And may it relate to each one who's watching this and to all of you here on the screen as well. So here goes. No, I have no music, no background music. It's just going to be a cappella. When I am down, and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come, and my heart burdened be, when I am still and wait here in the silence, until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Wow! Amazing, fabulous.
Thank you, that was lovely.
Really lovely, totally got teary. That happens to me now in lockdown. I don't know, out of the blue, I'm either really happy or suddenly I'm like, crying. I don't know if any of you
Tara, anyway. Tara, let me tell you something. Just cry when you have to. I cry every day. But it doesn't matter because it's cathartic. It's but lovely. There's bizarre. Nothing wrong in crying. I cry almost every day twice. Don't worry about it. I must tell you,
I completely forgot to say I would have liked to call them in because they're only 9 and 11. But one of the silver linings is they're two brothers, our kids, and they've been jamming in lockdown. And one plays the piano, one plays the drum pads. He's not yet got to the drums. And they've been singing The Scientist by Coldplay. And it's been so lovely, but they won't let me, if I put their name in for a show or something, they don't allow it. So of course, me being a social media person, I quickly try and take a video when no one's watching and post it. Because it's so touching. And this is music that has come, you know, children have just gravitated to. So I think this is just, you know, it's such a great thing that you've done because it's really something that everyone resonates with, wonderful music. So on that note,
thank you very much.
So much. Thank you. And please, all our viewers, please donate at www.magicbus.org. And thank you all so much for having me and for everything you shared. And everyone, please go and hear the wonderful, wonderful track. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Au revoir. Namaskar, namaskar, sat sri akal. Bye.
Bye. Matthew, do you remember Blind Date in England? Did you ever watch Blind Date?
Who, me?
No, I'm saying Matthew.
Oh, okay.
It was 6:30 on Saturday night.
Okay, no, because she used to say, Cilla Black used to say, ta-ra, ta-ra, ta-ra.
Matthew, the wheels of the bus go round and round. Round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round. Around we will go. Thank you so much, Matthew. Lovely joining up with you again. Bye, Pritesh. Bye, Tara. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Love you so much.
Bye, Tara.
Bye.
Take care.
Bye.